Hey there, what is up? It's Arushi and today I'm going to be doing a video related to acne. Now a lot of you guys messaged me and asked me to do another video related to acne, and I've already done one related to skincare and the products that you should use. So if you haven't watched that already, the link will be in the description so you can check that out. So before we get started with the video, I just have a few things to say. Now I'm going to be talking about two things. One is face mapping, which is basically a Chinese technique in which you get to know the root cause of acne on the particular part of your face, like your upper forehead or like your chin or your cheek, nose, etc. And then I'm also going to be talking about products. So I'm going to be talking about the products that have worked for me and which I personally use. So my skin is oily, like it's not oily, it's not dry, so it's combination skin. And if you have combination skin, then I'm pretty sure these products will work out for you too. But before you go ahead and buy or use any of these products, just make sure to test them out so that you don't break out, etc. That's all I have to say, and without further ado, let's get started. Alright, now let's get started with the face mapping first. So I'm going to be inserting a picture in which I'll show you how basically you divide your face according to the face mapping. So first of all, let's talk about your upper forehead. So if you're breaking out on your upper forehead, that might be because of bad ingestion, and that might be because of excess junk food and excess sugar in your diet. So to get rid of that, all you need to do is eat better food, like improve your diet and take more of citric acid and more of greens, include a lot of greens in your diet. Also, try drinking lemon juice at least twice a day, so that might really help. So if you have breakouts on your nose, that might be because of high BP or again because of stress. Another cause is sebum, so I'm going to be talking about sebum at last separately because sebum is a totally different topic. So that is the main cause why you might have breakouts on your nose. To get rid of that, all you need to do is relax a little, go for a good spa day, and also please make sure that you go for a nice overall face facial to get rid of the sebum. So yeah. Alright, now if you have breakouts between your eyebrows, a lot of people think that if you have breakouts between your eyebrows, that's basically because of the threading or getting your eyebrows waxed. But that is not really the case. So if you have breakouts between your eyebrows, etc., it might be because of excess fatty foods you're eating or because of alcohol, excess alcohol consumption. So if you are a person who drinks, make sure that you don't have a lot and don't have excessive alcohol. Moving on, there is a common place where all of us do get breakouts. They're just near your ears, out here. Even I had breakouts here, and behind your ear or on your ear. So this portion is kind of really common. So the main cause of breakouts in this particular portion might be because of lack of water, like you might not be drinking a lot of water, and excess salt in your diet. So to get rid of that, just make sure you drink a lot of water, plenty of water, and make sure you consume less salt. Now this will also help you to kind of lose the excess water and salt weight. So if you kind of cut down on the amount of salt that you consume, you might also lose upon weight and acne on your face. Now if you have acne on your right cheek specifically, it might be because of smoking or any other respiratory disease or because of any allergy that you might have. So if you have a lot of acne, like active acne on your right cheek, make sure to consult a dermatologist because they might help. And if you have normal acne on your T-zone area, that might just be because of sebum, so yeah. Now comes the last portion on your face, your chin and your mouth area. So a lot of people tend to have breakouts here and here, like here. So the main reason of that might be a lot of fast food that you have been eating lately. So to get rid of that, just make sure you eat a little healthy. Don't totally cut down on your junk food, but like eat less of junk food. And like if you have two burgers per week, just have one. And don't go for like a large burger, go for a small burger. And also just make sure that you include a lot of roughage in your diet, and that's about it. So that is basically all you needed to know about face mapping. And if you have any further questions, I'll leave a few links in the description box below so you can totally check those out. And if you have any more questions, you can also ask me on my social media. So all my social media handles will be in the description box as well, so make sure to check those out. Now I'm going to be moving on to the products: face washes, cleansers, masks, and a few makeup products as well. So if you have normal breakouts, you might totally want to continue watching the video. And I just want to clear a few things out. I have combination skin, which is neither dry nor oily. So if you have combination skin, the products might work out for you. But either way, just make sure that you test the products out before you purchase and try them. and use them on your skin, because you might break out if you have sensitive skin. And if you have a really active acne problem, make sure to visit a dermatologist and not just blindly trust any particular product. Now let's move on to the products. Now let's talk about face cleansers. Now you might know that the main cause of acne is sebum, like excess sebum in your pores. Now that is basically why you get breakouts and you get bumps in your skin. Now to get rid of that, you might want to ensure that you wash your face and that you have a clean face, and you also might want to exfoliate at least twice a week. Now I personally recommend this product. This is a Neutrogena Pink Grapefruit Foaming Scrub. So it's an exfoliator as well as a cleanser together, and this is an amazing product. You might not get this easily in India, but you might get this off Amazon. It's kind of expensive, but it's totally worth the money. So you might want to get your hands on this. Now what this does is that it has salicylic acid, which is totally nice for acne treatment. But if you don't really want to spend a lot of money on this, you might as well want to buy any face cleanser which has salicylic acid. So that does the job as well, and you're good to go. Like I said earlier, it's not very easy to get your hands on the oil-free Neutrogena Foaming Scrub. So I have a few alternatives for it. One is something that you can find at home, and two of them are something that you'll have to buy. So one is kind of pricey and the other one is not that pricey, and both of them work really well. So the first one is the Tea Tree Skin Clearing Facial Wash by The Body Shop, and I totally love the Tea Tree edition in The Body Shop. It is really nice for people with acne and blemishes. So this might not get you rid of the pimples and the breakouts overnight, but this totally helps you to get rid of the blemishes, and if you use this regularly, you might totally see the results in your skin totally clearing out. But if you don't really want to buy anything from The Body Shop, because not a lot of people really like Body Shop because they have to spend quite a bit here, the other alternative for you is the Himalaya Herbals. Now this one is specifically for people with oily skin, but I have combination skin and it totally works out for me. And I particularly use this after removing my makeup, so to get rid of the oil that I've used to remove my makeup. Now this one is the Lemon Foaming Face Wash by Himalaya Herbals, and this is really nice. So if you want to get rid of the excess oil, the sebum on your face, you might want to use either the foaming scrub, which is kind of really pricey. The other one you can use is the Body Shop Tea Tree Oil. And the last alternative is the Oil Clear Foaming Face Wash. This is really nice. Now that was all about the face cleansers. Now moving on to the exfoliators and the face scrubs. So I basically love Neutrogena as a brand. So the first preference of mine would be the deep clean blackhead eliminating daily scrub. Now you might want to totally remove all the blackheads and the whiteheads on your face, because that is basically nothing but sebum, and sebum is the main cause of acne. So you might want to go ahead for a blackhead clearing scrub, and this one is my personal favorite. I use it a lot, and this is kind of pricey for a face scrub, so you might want to go ahead for a cheaper one. So for a budget friendly one, you might want to go for the Clean and Clear Blackhead Clearing Scrub. This is good as well, but this is the best. So if you want to really invest into some products to get rid of the sebum and the blackhead, you might want to get the Neutrogena one. But if you don't really want to invest a lot, you might go for the Clean and Clear one. Now that was all about scrubbing and exfoliating. So just make sure that you at least exfoliate your face twice a week. Now apart from exfoliating and cleaning your face, you might also want to use a really nice face mask. So I have two that I would totally recommend, and one more. Yeah. So I would recommend three face masks for you. And I would also want to recommend the multi-face masking technique, which is basically using a particular kind of face mask for a particular part of your face. Now I use two face masks. One of them is a clay-based one and one of them is a mud-based one. So the mud pack by Himalaya is really nice for a really nice glowing skin, and it clarifies your skin. And the other one is a clay mask. Now clay masks are usually known for clearing out the sebum and to get rid of blackheads. So I use the clay mask in this portion of my face and the mud pack all over my face. So I use a multi-face masking technique. And another thing that I would want to recommend is, if you have active acne and an active breakout problem, you would want to go for the Neem face mask by Himalaya. It works really well for people who have breakouts. Moving on from all the face cleansers and all the exfoliators, I'm going to be talking about the other three really necessary products. Now, I really want to talk about a sunblock, a gel for people who have acne, and a moisturizing lotion. Now, first let's talk about the sunblock. Now if you're really prone to redness and breaking out, you might want to use a sunblock before you step out of your house during the summers. So make sure that you use a sunscreen which is more than SPF 30, because less than SPF 30 won't really work or have any effect on your skin. So I use this one, which is the Extreme Sunblock Cream by Lotus, and it is SPF 60, so it works pretty well. Now the second thing that I'm going to be talking about is the Lactocalamine Skin Balance Daily Nourishing Lotion. Now moisturizing your face is really necessary even if you have an oily or a combination skin. Now people who have oily skin are usually apprehensive to use a proper lotion for their face, and this one totally is okay for the people who have oily skin. Now this works for all skin types, for dry skin, oily skin and combination skin. I have combination skin and this works for me, and this also claims to get rid of the blemishes that you might have, the scars that you might have, because this has aloe vera. So this is a really nice face moisturizer that all of you might want to buy. Now the last thing that I'm going to be talking about is a skin gel. Now I purchased this in a local supermarket, and this one is the aloe vera skin nourishing gel, and this also has green tea in it and vitamin E oil. Now this is a really nice product. All I do is I sometimes use this as a primer, or sometimes after washing my face I use this as a moisturizer, because this works really well as a moisturizer. And aloe vera gel is something that you would want to include in your daily skincare routine, because it is really nice for breakouts, for blemishes and for acne scars. So it's an all-in-one skin product. The next product that I'm going to be talking to you guys about is one of my personal favorites, and I swear by it. Now this one is the Shack Love Cream by Shehnazuddin, and it is amazing for people who have breakouts and want to get rid of them overnight. Now this is not for people who have active acne, which is a medical condition. This one is for the people who have random breakouts because of a particular product, or just because of your skin, really acne or something that you put on your face. So this is for those. Now the purpose of this cream is just, you can just apply a little bit on the breakout or the bump that you have in your skin. Leave it for 20 minutes or leave it for overnight preferably, and then when you wake up you won't have it. So it dries the thing off and it kind of reduces the bump, the redness on your skin. So this is amazing for the people who want to get rid of a pimple, a particular pimple in general, overnight. And this is not for the people who have active acne, that is a medical condition. So please go ahead and talk to a dermatologist and consult a dermatologist if you have active acne. Now moving on to the last segment of the video, I'm going to be talking about makeup. Now before that, I just wanted to say, if you guys want a detailed review on the Shack Love Shehnazuddin cream, make sure to comment down below telling me you want a review, and I would love to do it for you. Now moving on to the makeup. People who have acne or have had acne in the past might have enlarged pores out here on your T-zone area. Now for that, people go for a primer. What primers do is they fill in your fine lines or enlarged pores and give you a proper canvas to work on, which is a face. But if you don't really want to use a primer and you want a primer and a foundation altogether, I would want you guys to go ahead and use the Weightless Mousse Foundation by Lakme. Now this is just like a primer, its consistency is just like that of a primer, and this works like a tinted primer of sorts. So using this, you will also get rid of all the visible pores you have in your skin, and this is kind of really suitable. But this does not have high coverage, so if you want a really heavy duty high coverage foundation, this is not something you would want to use. But you can use this as the base. Moving on to a high coverage foundation, which is my favorite for the Indian skin tone, is the Maybelline Fit Me Foundation. Now I'm in the shade 230. This is a very frequently asked question. I'm in the shade 230. I do not use foundation on daily basis. I do not use makeup on daily basis, just because I don't like to. Not because makeup is bad for your skin or anything, just because I don't really like to apply makeup. But whenever I do apply makeup, I go for either the Weightless Mousse Foundation or the Fit Me Foundation, and this is the best. Now this is heavy duty, so this will also help you cover all your acne scars or your blemishes, etc. Now if you don't want to use a foundation, you might want to go for a concealer, and my personal favorite is the L'Oreal True Match Concealer. Now this is a little pricey. This retails for about 995 rupees for this much, so people sometimes don't really want to spend on it. But if you are really someone who would spend on a really nice product, then go ahead and buy this one. This is a heavy duty, heavy concealer which really gets rid of any dark circles or even really heavy acne marks. So you would totally want to use this one. And I'm in the shade N45, and this works really nice. So if you want any foundation or concealer, go ahead for the L'Oreal Too Much Concealer, and for the foundation you would want to use Fit Me Foundation, and for the base of your makeup you might want to go for a primer, but if a primer is too pricey for you, you might want to go for the Lakme Mousse Foundation. So that's it for the video. I tried to cover as many products as I could in a particular video. So I talked about cleansers, scrubs, gels, etc. And I really hope this video helped you. Also, if you guys want me to give a detailed review about any product that I mentioned in this video, then make sure to comment that down below and I would love to do a particular review. And make sure that you subscribe to my channel and give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it and if this video helped you. If you subscribe to my channel, you'll basically be notified whenever I post. And there are quite a few fun videos coming up, so make sure that you subscribe. And that is all I had to say. So until then, bye!